All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory due to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Wahar Kakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. And peace and salutations to the hopeful elect out of your toiling in this truth. I'm Pathaka Moth, GMS Dallas, and I'm just coming back at you with a really quick hit lesson. And I'm going to simply entitle this one, "The Lord is about to judge this place and these people." You know, and that's what's going on, man. The Lord is about to judge because we're in a time of judgment. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of things are happening in the earth of a wicked proportions. You know what I'm saying? Adultery, you know, people eating abominably. You know what I'm saying? Celebrating these wicked holidays, just all manner of madness and wickedness. You know what I'm saying? Because this earth, pursuing Isaiah, the 60th chapter and verse 2, is in darkness, and these people in gross darkness, you know, which represents the lies, the deceptions, the evils of this place, man, you know, which have been instilled. That vibration and spirit has been instilled and has been instilled in this place by the current rulers. You know what I'm saying? Esau, Edom, which consists of the so-called white man, woman, and child in these times, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, the Lord is about to judge, man. He's about to judge this place and these people. And don't get it twisted. The Lord judges on a daily basis. As a matter of fact, real quick, let's just get that real quick. And what's that in? Zephaniah, I believe it is. Zephaniah, the third chapter. This is Zephaniah chapter 3 and verse 5, and it reads, "The just Lord, Yahweh Bashmiel Shai, is in the midst thereof. He will do nothing, Salaki. He will not do iniquity." Let me start that again. Zephaniah 3 and 5. "The just Lord, Yahweh Bashmiel Shai, is in the midst thereof. He will not do iniquity. Every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. He felleth not, but the unjust know no shame." And the point is, he brings his judgment to life every morning. So the Lord judges on a daily basis. But there's a specific time of judgment pursuant to the scriptures, man, where the Lord is going to actually visit and judge the earth, man. You know what I'm saying? Many, many, many babies are being born in these times, coming into the earth. You know what I'm saying? As a matter of fact, one of the things that inspired this lesson, my daughter called me today and told me she was pregnant, having a baby, man. You know, I think it's supposed to be born in May, you know, but or something like that. She's pregnant. So I'm thinking, wow, you know what I'm saying? The first thought came to my mind was the fact that, you know, these children, these babies that are being born in the earth in these times, you know, is coming into the earth for judgment, man. You know what I'm saying? And these are the times we're in. You know what I'm saying? So the Lord is about to judge, man. He's about to visit the earth. You know what I'm saying? And that's what's going on, man. You know what I'm saying? So real quick, let's go over to the Apocrypha real quick. And get that in 2 Esdras, the 9th chapter. And we'll just start at the top of verse 1 and read a couple of verses, which will make the point. This is 2 Esdras chapter 9 and verse 1. From the top, it reads, "He answered me then and said, Measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made." And there it is, man, which is the point. You know what I'm saying? We're in a time of visitation, judgment. You know what I'm saying? And when you go into that word visit, it literally means punishments, man. You know what I'm saying? So the Lord is about to visit or punish the world which he made, man. You know what I'm saying? So real quick, let's just prove that point. And then we'll come back. I just typed in Google visit, you know, which is, you know, a couple of different definitions for the word. You know, there it is. You can see visit. I'll let him
visit.
So visit, and the first definition says go to see. It's a verb. It says go to see and spend time with someone socially. You know what I'm saying? So, but that's not the one. Let's go to the second. Let's drop down to the second definition. Right there it says, number two, it says inflict something harmful or unpleasant on someone. So the visit can mean to inflict harm or something unpleasurable on a person, man. You know what I'm saying? Which is the one that's going to happen when the Lord visits the earth in which he made, man. You know, he's going to inflict harm, man. It's going to be very unpleasant, you know, and we're coming into those times, man. As a matter of fact, real quick, let's go to the etymology. And let's see what the etymology says. Visit, it's a verb. So, and we'll read this. It says visit, a verb, around the 1200 century. It says come to a person to comfort or benefit, from old French visiteur, to visit, inspect, examine, afflict. Hello, afflict, 12th century, and directly from Latin visiter, to go, to see, come to inspect, frequentive of vizier, behold, visit, a person or place, from past participle, stem of vidir, to see, notice, observe, originally of the deity, later of pastors and doctors, 13th century, or the 1300s, it says general sense of pay, a call, is from mid 13th century, meaning come upon, afflict, there it is again, in reference to sickness, punishment, etc. There it is. That's the one right there, highlighted in blue, if you couldn't follow. It says punishment right there, man. So the visit means to punish, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, real quick, let's go back to the verse in 2nd Ezra, the 9th chapter, because these are the times we're in. We're in a time of punishment of the Lord. That's why the Lord is allowing so many people on the planet Earth. You know what I'm saying? He's never allowed this many people at one time to be on the earth, man. You know, and again, 2nd Ezra 9 and 1, he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And how do you do that? By way of the scriptures, man, the prophecies of the Bible. You look into the earth and you filter things that are happening through the prophecies, the scriptures, through the prophecies of the scriptures. And you filter them through that to know what time we're in, to know what's going on, man, because the Bible is the ultimate measuring tool, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, and as a matter of fact, it references that, I believe, it's in the Revelation, the 11th chapter, you know, that rod, that reed for measuring, man. It's talking about the Bible, man, to measure the court. It says, and when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, and how does the Lord tell these things? By way of the mouth of his holy prophets, man, since the world began, as the scriptures say. It says, then shalt thou understand that is the very same time wherein the highest, the most high, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, will begin to visit or punish, afflict, harm, those unpleasantries, to visit the world which he made, to visit, to punish, man, the world which he made. So we're in the times of those things in these times, man. And that's why all of these new spirits, these babies are being birthed, man, being born into the earth in these times, man, you know, because the Lord is about to visit, about to punish, man, you know. So hey, it is what it is, but we're definitely in those times, man. And the earth, you know, these people have become wicked as hell, man. You know what I'm saying? Wickedness is at an all-time high, man. You know, you got Jake out here saying that the Lord effed up creation, you know. Wow. Several times over, as a matter of fact. She, you know, the wicked ass female, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's wicked as hell. You know, you got Jake out here. They're atheists now. You know, they don't believe in the creator and a creator and the Most High. You know what I'm saying? You know, this is how far gone our people are now. You know, this is the point we're at. This is where things have come, you know. So just with those, of course, you know what a heathen are, man. You know, they're outside the temple. They're outside the court. They're not, you know, so they're wicked anyway. You know what I'm saying? But you got Jake, who are the chosen people of the Lord. You know, he chose them to be his people, you know, And this is what they're doing, man. You know what I'm saying? So everything is just through in these times, man. Wicked as hell. And the Lord, it's time for judgment, man. You know, the Lord is about to judge this place and these people, man. So real quick, you know, because, you know, that we're going to stay in Ezra's. And we're going to go to the 15th chapter. And we'll start at verse, really, we'll start at the top at verse 1, and we'll read down, because wickedness has polluted the, you know, exceedingly polluted, like it's going to go into the whole earth, man. This second Ezra 15 and at the top of verse 1, and it reads, "Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy," you know, which is what we're doing, man, you know, because Yahawashi, pursuing the revelation of the 19th chapter and verse 10, is the spirit of prophecy, you know. Baruch 39 and 1, you should be occupied in prophecy. And as we're reading here, the Lord is telling us to speak into the word, into the ears of his people, the words of prophecy. And of course, in Peter, it tells us we have a more sure word of prophecy. So it's all about prophecy, man. The prophecies, you know, Habakkuk goes into it. Those visions, you know, make them plain upon tables, you know, and run. He may run that readeth it. You know, that's what we're doing. We're the modern day heralds. We're the runners, man. We read this and now we're running and warning, man. You know what I'm saying? Just like Paul Revere, the redcoats are coming. He was a herald in that time and he was warning, man, you know. So we've gotten that same warning by way of Yahawah Shemiah Shai, by way of the prophecies, man. And we understand and know what's coming, man. You know, so it says, "Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written on paper, for they are faithful and true." And that's what the Bible represents, man. It's the book is faithful and true, man. The words written contained within in it is going to come to pass, man, because the Lord said it in Isaiah 55 and 11, his words shall not return to him void, but it'll accomplish the thing whereto he sent it. He's a man that he can't lie. So these things have to happen. They have to come to pass, man. That's why they're faithful and true. Verse 3, "Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speaketh against thee." And that's talking about the majority of our people, man. Two third of the nation of Israel is against this knowledge, man. You know, but the Lord said, "Fear not the imaginations against thee." Don't worry about them, man. He tells us in the scriptures to make our foreheads hard against theirs, you know. So we don't worry about their looks. We're not worried about Jake, you know. The Lord's going to deal with Jake, you know, if they got a problem with this. So it says, "Let not the incredulity or the non-belief of them trouble thee that speak against thee," you know. So don't let the non-belief of two-third of my people trouble you. Just do what I told you. Warn them. Get the blood off your hands. You know, what's that? Ezekiel, the third chapter, starting around verse 17, all the way down to 19. The Lord said, you know, warn them. That's getting the blood off your hand. But if we don't warn them, then their blood is going to be us, man, upon us, man. You know, and he going to kill them and then he going to deal with us as well, man. But if we warn him, you know what I'm saying, do as he told us, then he going to kill them. But we're exonerated, man, you know, and that's what we're looking to do. We're getting the blood off our hands, man, because the Lord is about to visit this place, man. It says, verse 4, "For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction." And these things are all about to hit very hard in the earth, man. You know what I'm saying? It's about to be a reality check in this place, man. You know, these people ain't going to know what hit them, you know, because the Lord is finna hit hard and he going to hit often with all of these things we just mentioned, man. Because, you know, of course, these devils are manufacturing a major famine that's about to hit soon, man. You know what I'm saying? So the sword, the famine, the sword represents weaponry, you know, the famine, no food, death, in all manners of the word, and destruction, man. So these things are coming, man, from the Lord, man. Thus saith the Lord. Verse 6, "For wickedness," and this is why, he about to tell you why. "For wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their fruitful works are fulfilled," including two third of the nation of Israel, man. You know, that's what's going on, man. The wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth. Because why? because the earth has been given into the hand of the wicked, man. You know, this dude is Job 9:24. This dude is ruling over us right now, man. You know, and that's the spirit and vibration. You know, left hand, wickedness, evils, lies, deceptions, death, destruction. All of these things come along with the rulership of these devils, man. You know what I'm saying? So if the wicked is ruling, what is that going to bring? Wickedness, you know, he's the border of it. The scriptures tell you that in Malachi, the first chapter, man. You know what I'm saying? He's the border of wickedness. You know, so if the wicked is ruling, then wickedness is what's going to the vibration that's going to be instilled and put out, man. You know what I'm saying? So real quick, let's jump over to Revelations, the 19th chapter, because our Lord and Savior, our big brother Yahushua, is about to visit this place, man. He's coming, and he's not coming happy. He's not coming in a good mood, man. He's mad as hell, you know, because his father is mad, man. His father's mad. It tells you in Psalm the 7th chapter. As a matter of fact, let's get that real quick. Psalm the 7th chapter. Psalm 7, and I believe like around 12 or somewhere in there. 11, 12. 11, con. This is Psalms chapter 7 and verse 11, and it reads, "The Most High judgeth the righteous, and the Most High is angry with the wicked every day." You know, so the Lord is angry with the wicked on a daily basis. And of course, the wicked is ruling, you know. So there's a vibration that the wicked has put in the earth. All of these nations have taken hold to that vibration. And even 2/3 of the nation of Israel, the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you know, who make up the true biblical Israelites, Hebrew Israelites of the Bible, man, the Lord's chosen people. And they've attached themselves and taken hold of the wickedness of these devils, man. You know what I'm saying? And the Lord is going to judge for these things, man. You know, judgment is coming. So let's go back real quick. Let's go to Revelations, the 19th chapter. And we're going to jump down to verse 11. The coming of Hamashiach. There it is, right there in the heading. Revelation 19:11. "And I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse." Which that white horse represents that chariot of purity and cleanliness that our big brother Yahushua is going to be upon. "And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse." Horse represents power. "And he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True," Yahushua. "And in righteousness he doth judge and make war." There it is, man. So he's coming to judge this place and these people, and he's going to make war with these current rulers, man. You know, Esau and these heathen nations that's in joint air with him on the left side, on the left-hand side, man. You know what I'm saying? And that's what's going on, man. But we are definitely in a time of judgment. It says he's returning to judge, and in righteousness he doth judge and make war. So he's coming to judge, man. You know what I'm saying? Because we're in a time of judgment. So real quick, let's go to Psalms, the 9th chapter, and we're going to drop down to verse 16. This is Psalms 9 and 16. It says, "The Lord, Yahweh Shemel Shai, is known by the judgment which he executeth." Now, mind you, that was in the ancient, you know, when he was known to be Alashadia, you know, terrible demon-like power. Now, in these times, he's not known for that because due to these devils, that's the current rulers and Christianity, which they put in the world as flourishing. That's a total farce and lie, you know, teaching all these people that the Most High is all love. You know, he's an all loving power. You know, you can basically do what you want and he'll still accept you. You know, no, man, you know. The Lord is known by the judgment which he executed. Yeah, he was known by that, which in the coming times, he's going to be known by that again, you know, because those names are going to be reintroduced, reinstated and reintroduced in the earth. And along with those names, that reverence, that fear, you know, that judgment, they're going to know, man, because all these things are going to be attached to those names, man. So these people are getting ready to know Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, man, in the coming times. And he's going to be known for the judgment that he executeth again in these times, because these things are about to be reinstated and reintroduced. Psalms 9 and 16, "The Lord is known by the judgment which he executeth," and he's going to be known again for these things. "The wicked is snared in the work of his own hands." You know, so these devils about to be snared, trapped, you know, in the work of their own hands, man. So, and the Lord is going to make his name known, that fear known. That reverence is going to be known. Those judgments are going to be known, man. You know, when he deals with these devils, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, that's what's coming, man. You know, the Lord is about to judge the earth. So, let's get Proverbs real quick. Proverbs, keep this thing going. It's Proverbs 28 and verse 5. And it reads, evil men understand not judgment, but they that seek Yahweh Bashem Yahushai understand all things. And 2/3 of the nation of Israel are in that spirit. They're evil men. You know, they're evil as fuck. Salaka, excuse my French. And they understand not judgment. They don't understand judgment, you know. But it says, but they that seek Yahweh Bashem Yahushai understand all things, which represents the elect, man. Nonetheless, the elect, the remnant that's returning in these times, pursuant to Isaiah, the 10th chapter, they understand these things. They understand all things because that's that gift that's been given to them, man. You know what I'm saying? Which was not given to the majority of the nation of Israel, man. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you know. So evil men don't understand judgment. As a matter of fact, when you read in Jeremiah, let's get that in Jeremiah, the 8th chapter, you know. The Lord tells you here, it's Jeremiah 8 and 7. It says, yeah, the stork in the heavens, Salakia, the stork in the heaven knoweth her appointed times, and the turtle and the crane and the swallow observe the time of their coming. But my people, you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans of Negro descent, know not the judgment of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. They don't know the judgments of the Lord, man, you know, because we just read it in Proverbs 28 and 5. Evil men understand not judgment, man. You know, and the majority of the nation of Israel is evil in these times, man. That's why the Lord is going to put them to death pursuant to Zechariah, the 13th chapter, man. You know what I'm saying? And verse 8, it says, two parts shall be cut off and die. But the one part, the remnant, you know, those that are returning in these times, you know, the elect, you know, shall be bought through the fire, man. You know, till the Lord is going to save his elect, man, which Lord willing I can be a part of. You know, so real quick, let's get Ecclesiastes, the 12th chapter, to continue to making the point. You know, we've got a few more and then I'm going to bring this lesson to a close. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 14. And it reads, for the Most High shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. You know, and that's, there it is. That's plain and to the point, man. You know, and like the title reflects, the Lord is about to judge this place and these people, man. You know what I'm saying? Again, Ecclesiastes 12 and 14, for the Most High shall bring every good work, Salaki, shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. And that's the time we're in, the time of judgment. You know, and there's a righteous a reward or judgment. And then you got the death, the destruction, you know, the desolation on the other hand, you know, that the Lord is about to give and bring to the majority of the nation of Israel. These other nations don't have a chance. We ain't got to speak on them, man. You know, they ain't got a chance, man. You know what I'm saying? So like, yeah. But let's get Matthew. Let's go to Matthew real quick. Just make a couple more points. What's that? Matthew 12 and 36, because Yahushua is going to, this is what, hey man, a lot of our people think they're going to go unscathed, man. You know, bro, they out here going hard, doing all manner of, you know, wickedness, evil, left hand. But this is what Yahushua says, red letters, Matthew 12 and 36. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment, which is the times that we're in. So you're about to give account of those things, those idle words, those wicked ass things that you did. You know what I'm saying? Verse 37, for by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words shalt thou be condemned. You know, and you got 2/3 of our people coming up against this thing, man. You know what I'm saying? You got the elect and 1/3 out here speaking the truth, and then in which they're going to be justified by those words, you know. And then you got 2/3 of our people that's out here coming up against them, trying to condemn them, telling them they're lying. you know, and they're going to be condemned by those words, man. You know what I'm saying? So, but it is, but the point is, all of these things are going to be brought forth and taken into account, man. You know what I'm saying? Every knee shall bow, you know what I'm saying? And all of us are going to go before the judgment seat of the Lord, man. You know what I'm saying? Scripture say that. So real quick, let's jump over to Matthew, the 25th chapter. And we're going to drop down to verse 31, I believe. Yeah, verse 31. And as you can see in the heading right there, it says the judgment, man. We're in time of judgment, man. Matthew 25 and 31. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. You know, and that's the left and right hand, man. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on his left. There it is right there, man. You know what I'm saying? The left and right. And 2/3 Esau, these nations, and 2/3 of the nation of Israel is going to be on the left hand. It says, then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come ye blessed of my father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Which that king is talking about Yahweh Shai, man. Talking to his elect, the 1/3, the remnant, man. And as a matter of fact, let's jump down to 41 to see what he's going to say to the left hand, including 2/3 of Israel. Esau, these heathen nations, and 2/3 of Israel. Matthew 25 and 41. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. And don't get it twisted. That ain't talking about some fiery eternal place in the center of the earth, man, or in the ground that you go to. No, man. That everlasting fire is talking about these thermonuclear missiles when they hit this place, man. You know what I'm saying? It's the Lord finna burn everything up, man. You know, he finna burn these people up. He finna burn America up. And he's gonna burn some other places as well, man. But he's not gonna destroy those like he's gonna destroy America, man. America is done. This place is finished, you know? So, what do I want from here? Let's get one more, because Babylon the Great, aka America, the great whore, is going to be destroyed, man. You know what I'm saying? So let's you know, go to that fire is going to touch this place. So real quick, let's get Revelations, the 17th chapter and verse 1. And it reads, the doom of Babylon in the heading, which is America, aka America, the great whore. It says, and there came one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials, and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither. I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters, which is talking about America. So that judgment is here, man, because we're in a time of judgment and the Lord is about to judge this place and these people, man. So real quick, one more. Let's get to Revelations 18. We're going to drop down to verse 10. And it reads, 18 and 10, it reads, standing afar off for the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon, which aka America, the great whore, that mighty city, for in 1 hour is thy judgment come. So boom, there it is. This place is about to get judged, you know, because we're in a time of judgment. The Lord is about to judge this place and these people. So with that, hopefully this was edifying to the hopeful elect, giving all praises, honor, and glory due to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Wahweh Kakwadash, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and blessings to the elect, the house of David, the Bayath Shah Dawadah Shalom.